Dear friends, the case study that I have explained, then now we are going to test that case study with respect to certain parameters. Actually, every case study, if you analyze, you will get the same picture. But as I have been repeatedly telling, it has missed out the eyes of IBBI. In this particular case, I was there for only 2 months. Then I was removed unceremoniously. Thereafter, I have been, from the day one when I started observing problems, I was keeping the IBBI informed. That matter became bigger. But then, chairman of IBBI used to send mails, all the top officials. I have all the records. So, not even one response we got. And then the senior officials talked to me, they shared the grievance of ours. Had they used this in 2017 itself, it would have been very different. Therefore, I would like to, because this is a letter which I have addressed to Honorable Prime Minister, and also this is a stand that I am taking before the public interest litigation that's coming up for hearing before the Honorable Patas. So the first part is going concern. Going concern is well established, that I have been talking a lot. Now in this case, how the going concern would have been helpful, I am talking. So I was appointed. And the first thing I have done is to ensure that the factory runs. And we had a detailed inspection. Organized structure is devised. Then they only assisted me. Please know, a person will go there in 1 month and all, he will not understand. In this particular case, as I was explaining, the promoter is interested to take back the company. And you will understand that Synergy Dure, Honorable Chairman was praising as a great achievement at that time. What is the great achievement? 900 crores, I think 800 to 900 crores is the exposure. And that company was taken over by the promoters for 50 crores, 40 crores. So the haircut is 860 crores. They paid 20 crores. So they are talk of the troubles. Then it was praised by the chairman like anything. So therefore, every promoter thought this is the best that we can use at earliest. All the brains, legal brains, the consultants started working on this. This is what is exactly happened. I remember. Prior to that, I saw the promoter. He realized that it will be difficult dealing with the situation. And he believed that I'll be able to recover the money. And therefore, he was terrified. I felt it is not great. Because as a businessman, we would like to analyze. But then the situation has undergone a change. First and foremost step is, okay, bankers have given money. That is 384 crores. That is past. That we will come back. Now the question is, the CIRP process, it has taken for them 450 days. That one thing. And there were a lot of resolution applicants came, and almost it was going through at around 300 crores. Terrific canvassing have done. But finally, that money, that is finally it is settled, I think bankers have approved now for 85 crores totally claim. And the promoter agreed to pay 5 crores. This is the before COVID came in. Then litigation is still under litigation. You see what happened to the nation's money. Who is responsible? Let us start. I don't want to say the cases when we put it. This is not one isolated case, friends. Everywhere this is the problem. Which IBBI totally ignored. Remember, this was informed to them daily basis. Mails. They have not come to the rescue. So what happened? We have prepared a plan. There are two things. Is a prawn culture. I was doing for one big company. We won the and then the Marine Division's award in India for that company when I was quite some time. Proms, export of proms, all that. This fellow was having a prom hatchery. He can buy the mother proms and then breed them, and then those can be sold. He has got good network throughout India to sell them. Promoter is expert in this business. He says he came to Chennai without any money, and he was able to get 1,000 crores from the bank, must discuss though. So we made a plan to make sure that this company is a going concern. That means machinery is in working condition. All the workers are paid their salaries. They are reduced. Large number of contract workers are there. Third one, taxes to pay to the government and other things can be paid. And then we worked out some big surplus so that the banks can also pay the CARP expenses. And also we worked out 1 crore rupees per month. That person came and worked out payable to the banks. I was thinking, my God, I've done everything. And within 1 month, I've done valuation. We got a nice report from these valuers. And with their advice, because that private bankers are very good. They were advising us how to do it, very kind concern. They look the CARP process differently from what these public sector bankers. Public sector bankers, two bankers, the lead bank was sending some person who doesn't know, sleeps there, that's all. These two retirement fellows will bombard you like anything. One fellow was about to retire in 2 months and DGM. Another person is by nature, he will abuse even the wife of the promoter. He gets happiness by doing like that. That gentleman is like this. So here is a situation where the promoter himself wants to bring that working capital, and he himself gave a plan, I will run it like this. I said, no problem, let us run it. Then I told him, you deposit some money, then I can tell the bankers that you have committed. Let's work out so that some good things can happen. And that is the first step took place. Then we don't know that promoter, every day one must this car will come to my house, it's there. Their accounts team, they help. If they don't help, what you can do? The IDBI don't know, so they write, you take control immediately. You have to remove this person. That is, there's so much in legislation. How is it possible? A massive company, so many thousands of workers dealing with them. One is company problem, then is regulatory compliances, legal work, and then fees is peanuts, L1. So, they have completely ruined this legislation. Let me see, we'll see. The High Court I'm going, so therefore, I can bring anybody to answer the questions and let us see. So, that particular, who has disturbed it, two things have happened. One is when the law, Supreme Court, they are not bothered. Their legislation is not there to tell that COC must share. COC cannot tell that we will not share. We already threw money. Who threw your money? Whose money is that? This is the money of the public, you people threw it. And now, see, they have written off already. Whatever you are going to get is extra. Where is their loss? When you want to get 400 crores, you are not interested to give even 20 crores. In this case, there was no need even for that. The promoter is willing to. They said, no. You put the lock and key like that, that the people will advise you. What you can do? You cannot do anything. Now, the IBBA recently won discipline case. He is independent man. If he is not independent, it is as he has not done his duty. Therefore, 6 months they removed. What is this? That means they don't know the ground reality. And if you are independent, and what you can do, you tell me. Here the promoter wants to give money. Here the COC says don't. And you can't do anything. Can you go to the court and tell NCLT? The next minute they will pass 66% removal. And no reasons are given, that is not justiciable. And what can the RP do in this case? Please tell us. So that is one. Second, How can you adjust that money given by promoter during the CIRP process against their advance? You cannot. Section 14 is there, moratorium on this. These people wantonly flouting the law. Correct? No. Now, who will have to file the case? Can he file? Can he file? So there should be a provision. What is the provision? Very simple. If the IBBI has done some research, small fellows would have been sent to do the research. In this case, problem I am telling, they are not reading. They are busy always claiming credit. You can see this credit getting only, everything, reality is after 4 years only like that, they are thinking. What they should have done, non-legislation. The RP's duties include keeping a going concern, already said. What he should do? What he should do? He should estimate the fixed expenses. He should estimate, not this IBB. What is your businessman? What is right? You will know. I will decide my organized structure, the salaries that I have to pay, the workmen, everything fixed costs, I will say, which is payable, which is not payable. It's a running concern I want to create. This is the fixed cost. Reduce. From, if you say 10 crores, I will bring it to 5 crores, bare minimum. And then for 5 crores, I need contribution. So, what is the product mix? And what is the working capital required for it? That's all. And this working capital, they must bear in proportion to their voting share. What is the CARP class? You see, CARP class anywhere. I remember, I tell you recently one case. They thought so much to pay the RP salary. Literally, they said in one very case, 1,500 crore company, they were telling me, there are people, RPs outside waiting for 25,000. They will stand in front of us. When we call, they will come inside. So you don't think too much. I said, you appoint them. Then finally, this being a big troublesome case, they gave me. Remember what they would have paid me for that for 12, 14 months, that's gone now. They appointed process advisors. They will appoint, that's all. You need process advisors. And what the process advisor bid for. And what he will do, whatever the data he will give, he will put it in nice format and send it back to them. He didn't get anything. 1 crore rupees is the fees agreed for. All the COC approved. So, what is that you can do? Auditor, RP should be independent and he should decide. Otherwise, that 1 crore has to be repaid. Who will pay? This is judgment of disciplinary committee. What you can do? So, therefore, there should have been a law like that. First law is section 27 should be amended to make sure that the auditor, the resolution professional, whenever they want to remove, they two things. First of all, you want to appoint a resolution professional. The financial creditor should not have power. All that he can choose 3% from the list of IBBI. Based on ranking, they have to do IBBI. Not giving everybody who knows or doesn't know, they'll give. You should rank based on experience. Already 3 years gone. And so you please see this man done so many works. Successfully done. How can you do successfully here? The banks are meant to kill. So, whether he's law knowledgeable, is that there should be some process, infrastructure, capability. Otherwise, how can you run a company? Just now, past person who is never having any work, he's put into the job. He's so scared, he gets that even 70,000 rupees a big money for him. He's running 1,000 crore company. You see, they have not IBBI, not done. Basic one, they have not addressed first. L1. They will not interfere. Somebody asked the chairman. He said, we are not going to interfere in the remuneration. Then what else will happen? Then what else can happen? Right. Now, when you want to remove the RP, let us say the RP can do mistakes also. They can be finding fault. Let them find a fault. But then when they want to replace, they should not put the person who is. Salary fees should be structured based on exposure. Second step is, again, these people should remove by voting. And thereafter, then three peoples that NCLT should get power of appointing RP based on the credentials. So So the power of appointment and removal should be removed from these financial creditors who are not accountable. Second step, that is very important. The law clearly says for section 14 moratorium, when the banker is not following the law, you have to punish him. You have to, there should be fine imposed. What only you are delaying the process. The object is time bound resolution. And this is delayed because of this. And you are excluding that delays from the computation of CARPP. Honorable Prakash Kumar sir very clearly said, the delay reduction of section 13 has come. You have to establish exceptional circumstances. Delay, if legal delays are there also, you should correct that delay to the affecting the CIRP process. Correctly analyzes. That is the intention of legislature, a time-bound resolution. Everybody wants to take. Another problem, you know, you can delay, you have to file case, then with mistakes, then the case will never come up for hearing. You go ahead and do what you want. Then what is the problem of the duration? That also they are not clear. So loopholes, they don't know how to remove. So therefore, there should be some provision that when public sector bankers, whoever it is, in particular means public sector, they are not supposed to. And on the general manager recovery in charge, case to be filed. And he can pass strictures, make him respondent. The problem would have solved just like that. Here I would like to tell my friends, in this particular case, the personal guarantee was on the wife of the promoter. He was scared that they may put it against him. Why you have not introduced that corporate guarantee, individual's corporate guarantee? That would have given electric results. They waited and recently introduced. I don't know anybody has filed the case. You see, there also they put for provision. The RPR, liquidator of the corporate debtor, should not act as a bankruptcy trust. He would have had more knowledge, more experience, more assets, everything he would have known. He can move and collect the money. You see, there are actually many people told us that legislation drafted by IBPA is so confusing that the more litigation is because of that legislation. They are amending law on us. So therefore, what do you call it? Let them defend. Then CIRP process is the main, we are saying, Supreme Court said, NCLAT said. Then why is the provision to facilitate it? They are not listening to the thing moratorium, they are not bothered. Bankers, financial creditors, who will file a case? You want RP to be independent, but that fellow can be removed by them without hearing reasons. What RP can do? So you have killed this legislation. That is one thing clear. Here is a company was going with concern and that all gone. Now I told you the result is 5 crores they are getting out of 500 crores. The balance they will call it resolved, but when we don't know. That will be again written off. That is what is going to happen. First case. Second, we are going to test that against treatment of RP. My experience I am telling you. What is the treatment of RP I got and my predecessor got? My predecessor was, you know, literally abused by these two fellows. Then when I came into the picture, I used to bring all my articles also to help assist me. So much stuff and all these things, a lot of work. It is not one day talking to that fellow full day stuff. Promoter will sit, his accountant will sit. They are just going on watching us. And that fellow will only abuse him. First of all, he doesn't know law and I also don't know law. Both of us are reading the provision, which is confusing also. That particular time, the law is emerging. That's what he's telling. Ecosystem is emerging like that. So very simple things, why the ecosystem should develop. He didn't do that. So, this treatment is so vast. And alright, I wanted to conduct a forensic audit. Because I felt 320 crores will come back if you file case against the promoter. The clear cut case. Everybody told me don't do that. Because the top chairman is involved. They are very close. Now my question is, if I don't do, independent opinion. That time that provision is not there. Even the honorable Tariq sir told me, why are you insisting like that? Because nowadays RPs can be killed also, criminal cases are being filed. And you have to think like that, he told me actually, but that time. But of course, you'll talk in the open for so many, then the order will be totally differently passed in my case. That's it. So, this person, the chairman, was directly involved in my matter. Reason I didn't know was very, very forceful. And the independent director of that bank was my student. He's the past president of ICA. I told that person, what is this man doing? I'm working for nation and this. So he told him, see, boss, he sincerely does the job. Oh, no, no, no. Once he defies me, I will remove him. And they could have removed us. And in the COC, fourth COC, very abusive. I could not, my throat got tied up the way they were insulting the two guys. And then there is another gentleman that they sent, very tough fellow. He'll be like a person coming to kick you. Very, very harsh. I saw him. Somebody told me he's a recovery. Whenever chairman finds the other fellow is tough, we will finish him. This man will come to attack. But all he asked me to, I'm chairman, COC, I was proceeding, chairman sitting. He asked me to first get out. We all have to discuss. I just went out. You know what I did do? I already told IBB everything. Everything I told them. They're sending off the chairman outside these things. What to do? Then they were in the thing. He said, we don't have confidence. You fellow don't know anything. That, this, that. He's gone like that. And they could have removed me by passing the resolution. But somehow something happened they didn't do. I told you, please next say think on, I'll agree, you pass it, I'll go. But they filed a case against me. Putting that I'm inefficient, all kinds of things. And they appointed top lawyer. And that lawyer, a gentleman will attack you. Oh, he'll shout. And this fellow is colluding with the promoters. Like that. The honorable judge Tariq sir told him, hey, he looks very sincere and he's doing job perfectly. Why are you making allegations against him? And you should file an affidavit. They filed the affidavit. They didn't leave me. And again they send on defamation notice from the chairman. Understand that much extent they attacked us. And where is the remedy? You can, IBBI have been keeping informed. They're literally not worried. Then NCLTI came. The judge was very favorable looked, but then order was totally in favor of the chairman passed. I went to NCLAT, Delhi. The case itself will not come. Then the judge, Honorable Abhukopadhyaya, he said, 27, we have taken decision. COC can remove. That's all he said. What you can do. Is it a law? The intention of law is very good. And who has spoiled it? You please tell me. This is what I wrote to Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister. It's a clear-cut case. And next, let us go to the next situation, resolution of claims. Since I prepared, because business, I know I'm a financial expert. I'm training only costing and strategic finance, advanced finance. I'm a teacher for CA final, so I must be knowing something. So what I did, and I'm also in a real seafoods business, I was running it successfully, a big company. Therefore, what I did is I prepared. And then I requested all the seafoods presidents or my friends, Empada and all that. There was a meeting going on in Goa. So I prepared everything and sent to proposal that payback period is like this in a short form. It is just marketing your product, not all the information. It's a, there is a company and not this company name also. And this is what is the payback period. Remember, we got 12 resolution applicants. 12. seriously interested to take it, but then we were removed. And I'm glad to note that they have told me that they also felt seriously that if I had been there, I would have got solution for it. Finally, 5 crores for 500 crores they got, and it is. So here, very important thing is Honorable Supreme Court in Sasidhar versus IOB. They took a decision. Commercial wisdom of COC is not justiciable, and they gave para 60. They gave some reasons. Second, in SR Steel, that's also they said. Retreated this time when the argument was test of reasonability and fairness is required in this case. What reason is whether the committee of creditors are capable of taking a business decision? That was not argued there. Committee of creditors are, I'm telling you, a person who is in recovery is coming and sitting. This is how our COC is functioning and what decisions he will take. And two, these retirement chaps, bankers, they are very egoistic. Suddenly they will dislike him. Then your head is gone. What for he is getting angry, you don't know. Because he is guy who can argue or give you any assignments or don't give assignments. If you clash with the bankers, next assignment they will not give. That is for sure. And what you will do? The IBB has no answers. Actually, IBB had done the greatest injustice because Honorable Supreme Court, they should have implicated. Honorable Supreme Court also should have called these people to know what's really the problem. They were telling there is a good realization compared to previous legislation. That is not the case. Many judgments of Supreme Court, if you see, they are talking like that only. Fairly all legislations are failed, whereas this legislation is correct like that. It is not so. Commercial wisdom, that's gave them sweeping powers. Here is the fellow, he is giving money wrongly. So the legislation, everybody knows, including the Prime Minister, was very upset because banks demonetization failed because of banks. That's what Prime Minister said. Later he shifted to chartered accountants because the resistance from bankers was very high. So he just felt that CAs are easy people to attack. That is what happened. And that means the banker is lending wrongly. Who doesn't know?